Now News 8's Commitment 2010 coverage. Tonight we're focusing on the 48th state senate race, which includes Lebanon, Lancaster, Dauphin, and Berks counties. Incumbent Republican Mike Folmer has represented the area since 2007. He's being challenged by Democrat Joe Ellen Litz. The state budget could be considered the biggest state issue in this election.
So 8 on Your Side government reporter Matt Belanger had the candidates take the money into their own hands to show us where they stand on spending and saving.
With 1,000 pennies and one unforgettable treasurer, our time in Lebanon's Monument Park is nearing an end. But before we go, it's incumbent state senate candidate Republican Mike Folmer's turn to try his hand at managing Pennsylvania's piggy bank.
And what we need to be doing is, no pun intended here, Matt, is that we need to be squeezing every penny out of every tax dollar that we are spending and making sure that the monies are being spent appropriately.
You have some changes in mind already. What would you do?
I'm looking at community and economic development, which is, to me, is corporate welfare. That has to end. I'm taking it all out.
The governor's a big supporter of these efforts.
He's also a big spender. I don't believe it's government's role to be making winners or losers in the business field. I believe that it's our responsibility to make sure it's an equal and fair playing field. The next cut, we're going to be taking three additional pennies from the legislature.
Your own pocket?
Our own pocket.
Now tell me about that.
Well, we need to live within our means. Just like everybody out there, we need to make sure that our offices are run as efficiently as possible.
How do you convince the legislature, your colleagues, to cut money set aside for this?
Well, we're already had a huge hiring freeze on. And we started being looking at that. Like I said,
but you think there's more that can be done?
Well, yes, I do. I think we need to look into it again.
Next, it was time to address the two largest expenses in the state budget, education and public welfare. They make up more than half of all state spending. Compared to some parts of the budget that only have one penny in funding, both areas have hundreds of pennies, representing billions of dollars. First to go, 33 pennies from public welfare.
Well, I'm taking 10%, and I'm basing that off of Auditor General Jack Wagner's recent audit on the Department of Public Welfare, which said there was upwards to a potential of $1 billion of fraud and waste in the Department of Welfare. I think we at least owe the taxpayers an in-depth investigation into it.
Next, a cut to education spending.
I'm going to take 12 pennies out, and I'll tell you why. I think we're spending a lot of money in education, and I think we should. I think it's, but it should be about, Matt, it should be about the child. Let's make sure it's about the child and make sure we're getting the results.
You've proposed cutting education, wiping out community and economic development, and even cutting funding to your colleagues. That's going to make a lot of people angry. What will you do as a candidate to try to convince the colleagues who may disagree with you fundamentally that this is the way the state needs to go?
Well, first of all my cuts and all my movements here have been based off of questions that have not been answered to me as a duly elected state senator, and that is wrong. And how can I support any type of tax increase, whether it's warranted or not, until I know that every penny that we're that's being spent out there is being spent properly? For too long, we haven't been asking the questions. For too long, we haven't been looking into every department, making sure that we're squeezing every penny out of every tax dollar.
With all of the pennies he's collected, Folmer has a plan.
If our highways and bridges were A-OK, you know, I would say take it all and give it back to the taxpayer, OK? Or maybe even keep some for a rainy day fund. But I think there could be a good case made that maybe we should shift the money's existing dollars without raising any taxes into transportation. You know, let's split the difference. Let's add some to transportation and then return some back to the taxpayers. We're going to do six here to transportation and back to the taxpayer, baby.
Other areas Folmer proposed cuts: emergency management, general services, and funding for the state row offices and executive offices. And this was a three-part report, Pennsylvania's Piggy Bank. So if you missed one of the segments, you can go and watch them all on WGAL.com.
You know, one thing you learn is that it's not an easy job these legislators have in Harrisburg.
You like the pig, Jim?
Well, he said back to the taxpayer, baby, so I'm thinking I'm going to take
your money in there.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It is. $10. All right, thank you, Matt.
Split it a lot of ways. Thanks, Matt.
Coming up